Really clashes. All right, here we go. The semifinals of the Wild Card Tournament here at a Midsummer's Nightmare 2. Topher Whiteman here with Classic Chris and the man who this tournament is named after, Danger Boy Derek Wilds. Both men here competing in their second match of the evening.
Why don't you ask me who's going to win this one?
All right, I'll start it up with that. Danger Boy, we got Deaner, we got Primo.
What did I say in the beginning?
Well, before you made it clear that Cody Deaner, if he wanted to win this, he could do it.
Right. So, and who won the first one?
Well, it was Cody Deaner victorious.
Yes. Like I said, morally, he's got some issues. But in the ring, there's no better.
Well, he's looking good so far.
If he wants to win, he will.
You know, a lot of these guys in this tournament you've faced in the past. You've had your battles with Primo.
Who is he, Deaner trained by?
I believe that would be you, the Neo Kojo.
Yes. Yes, I forgot about
that. Both these guys, you're students here. Who is the better student?
That's not really nice to say. I'm a nice guy. I can't really, you know.
Oh, come on. I got you here.
They all have their strengths and weaknesses. Let's say that.
Okay, on this particular night, here we are, August 17th, 2013.
Yes.
We have Cody Deaner. We have Primo Scordino.
Yes.
Both in their second matches of the night.
Yes.
Who has the edge?
Deaner.
Deaner, okay. And the reason being?
He has more experience. He's done more. He's been farther. He's been around the world. And like I said, when he wants to be, there is no better.
Well, right now he's in a precarious position. Primo's got him by the beard. I don't know why Renda's allowing this, but he is.
You have 5 seconds to break that hold. Take advantage.
Again, another five count here.
Yeah.
You know, Primo's seen some hard times thanks to Cody Deaner. It was just in June that Primo and Rhino teamed up against Deaner and Tyson Dukes. So they've locked horns quite recently. Some bad blood spilling over into this tournament.
I guarantee you that Deaner hasn't put one thought in what happened in the past, but he's thinking about right now and only right now.
So we have Deaner here living in the moment, getting quite a beating here from Primo Scordino. Oh, hard kick to the face. You know, Primo's got a lot of reason to win this thing. Sure, his partner's back now. He could go into tag team action, but Neo is Primo's home. This is his home base here in Niagara Falls. You know, winning the championship in his hometown has got to mean so much to him. Do you think that'll give him an extra edge here?
Obviously, he's a fan favorite. Sometimes it's an edge, but other times it can hold you back. If you care about what you look like in front of your friends and don't focus 100% on winning, definitely can hold it back.
But at the same time, a hometown audience can get that rally behind you to give you that extra oomph.
100%, I agree with you there. But like I said, it all depends how you look at it.
Well, I'll pass it over to Chris here. Chris, your pick, the professional Jackson Jarvis, was eliminated in the first round. Now the field's down to four. Who do you think has it?
Well, good thing there's four guys left. I'm going to say it's Cody Deaner. Like, just seeing him tonight, he's going to win it all. There's just that look in his eye. He's got Jay Moore by his side. You can't go wrong. He's resilient. Hands down, he's a thinking man's wrestler.
Oh, I got two Deaner fans beside me. I think I got to go with my man Primo. You know, when I first started out in this business, Primo was there for me. And Jay Moore being exactly where he should not be in the ring.
And it looks like he's going to pay for it.
Yeah, Primo's been waiting to get his hands on.
Primo doesn't want to play this game.
Oh, it was a ruse. It was a distraction to get Cody Deaner.
When it comes to brains, there's no smarter.
That's the advantage.
Did you teach him that, Danger Boy?
Jay Moore?
No, did you teach Cody Deaner to do that?
I tell you, right now that Jay Moore taught him to do that.
Oh, Jay Moore, getting into it with the fans here. I think that fan had a sign calling him fat or something.
Yeah, which I don't really understand.
No, if anything, he looks like he's starving.
Yeah.
Renda's got his back turned here. Jay Moore rolling Primo into the ring.
Jay was in the ring, ref! Pay attention! Ref, open his head! Ref!
Now, if there's one thing I'm sick of seeing at Neo Wrestling Federation, it's Jay Moore. Always getting involved in people's business, sticking his nose where it shouldn't be, changing the outcomes of matches.
You better watch what you're saying, because I know he's skinny and stuff, but I'm pretty sure he can still beat you up.
That remains to be seen. He can't even beat up the mat. With all due respect, Jay Moore is not an athlete.
No, he is not. But if it came to a hair pulling contest, you would lose.
Right. Who could pull the most hair? Yeah, I suppose. We went till there was none left. I'd win by default.
True. But I don't want to talk about that.
Dino, a Russian leg sweep here, covering up Primo. Now, do you think the hair is a distraction while we're on the topic of hair? Deaner's got that big beard. We saw Primo pulling at the beard, pulling at the hair.
I don't know. I like Deaner's Duck Dynasty look.
He's definitely styling, don't get me wrong, but I mean, if I was in the ring with this long hair, it'd be awful. I'd be getting dragged, you know, left and right by the hair.
I'm sure the girls in the ring with you would be nice to you and not pull your hair so much.
At least you give me some credit.
Yes. If by credit you mean you getting beat up by girls, yes.
All right, well, Cody Deaner made a career out of getting beat up by girls. He won a date with ODB and ended up becoming TNA Knockout Champion, the women's champion there.
Very true. It's a nice piece of history.
But I'm sure Deaner would love to once again wear the Neo Wrestling gold.
Come on, Deaner, stay up.
Oh, what a Deaner. What was that? He had something there. I can't see it from my vantage point. I don't know what it was.
No, I think he's just adjusting his belt.
Was it just his belt? We'll have to wait till the Toofy Cam comes out and see what he really had there.
Oh, I'm like, what the hell's a Toofy Cam?
The Toofy Cam. He's got
I get it now. Toofy with a cam.
That's correct. Yeah.
I know I've been hitting the head a lot, but I even got that one.
You watch this? It's over.
Yeah! Deaner, I don't know what he's doing on the second rope. Not like Deaner to take to the sky. I think he's wasted too much time here. Deaner!
Oh. Too smart for that.
Oh, but not for that. Or that.
Or that.
Primo's out-quicking him. A solid right hand there. That beard's not going to protect his face. Didn't you teach Deaner not to wrestle in jeans?
No.
Oh, Primo, the huge spine buster.
Over the tire.
Oh! That was like 2.9 right there.
That's resiliency kicking out right there. That was a hard spine buster.
And now Primo getting the support.
To help around here.
Primo getting the support of his hometown. Yeah. Off the ropes. Oh! Solid kick there. Knocks Primo off his feet. Not enough to keep him down for the three.
Deaner better get his mind into this. You don't want to get disqualified here.
Deaner's going for that corner, that big slice spread. Primo hangs on. Setting up for the Fishermans. He hooks him. Drops him. This is what got him the win earlier.
Jay Moore advantage strikes again.
How many times is Brian Renda going to fall for this? Come on, ref. Turn around, he's got a chain. Primo, duck. Oh, wait a minute. What is this? No, Renda. It's not what it looks like, Renda. No, no.
Does it again. Cody Deaner just pulled the wool over our eyes here.
Here is your winner as a result of a disqualification. Cody Deaner.
What a travesty that was.
Big demand wrestler.
Primo just got screwed out of a title shot and now he's going after Jay Moore. Until you die.